Hello friends. This video is dedicated to autonomous power sources, and we will take a look at the powerful Esager Power Bank, which boasts a claimed total output power of up to 120 watts, a capacity of 20,000 milliamp hours, and support for power delivery and quick charge protocols. I want to draw your attention to a very important point right away. Unlike a UPS, a power bank is not designed for constant use with simultaneous load and external power connected. It is used situationally for powering or charging a specific device, including a UPS. Then, it is recharged and stored in a disconnected state. If you use it in UPS mode, there is a risk that its battery may fail. I purchased this device as an additional external battery for my laptop, which seemed logical given the claimed output power. Before we begin, as always, I kindly ask you to like this video. It will help others interested in this topic find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Type of device, power bank. Model, Esager PB905. Maximum output power, 120 watts. Batteries, lithium polymer. Claimed capacity, 20,000 milliamp hours. As for the parameters listed with a slash, 15.4 volts and 18.5 watt hours, I couldn't figure it out, so feel free to share your thoughts in the comments below the video. Ports, USB-C, power up to 100 watts, bidirectional. iPhone, up to 10 watts for charging the power bank itself using lightning connector cables. USB-A, up to 22.5 watts for the first port and up to 18 watts for the second port. Built-in cables, USB-C, up to 65 watts. iPhone Lightning, up to 20 watts. Dimensions, 15.7 by 13.3 by 1.7 centimeters. I placed the order on November 30th during the Black Friday sale, and the cost was $39.54. It was delivered on December 24th, taking just over 3 weeks in total. The device comes in a flat cardboard box, which is quite hefty. The back of the box lists the device's specifications, including output power under various combinations of external port usage. I've already covered all the main points. The package includes the power bank and a small USB-A to USB-C cable, in addition to the cables built into the device itself. The hero of the review is quite large, almost square-shaped. At the top of the front side, there is a screen covered by a glossy insert, which, by the way, is prone to fingerprints. On the backside, at the bottom, the device's parameters are repeated, including information about the use of various output port combinations. As I mentioned earlier, the box was quite heavy. The device itself weighs 480 grams. On the sides, remember, the power bank is less than 2 centimeters thick. There are special grooves with built-in charging cables. One is a lightning cable for Apple gadgets. The other is a USB-C cable for everything else. For convenience, the manufacturer has provided special tabs which make it much easier to extract the cables. This is how they look when taken out of the grooves. Thanks to this, you won't face situations where you have the power bank but no cable to use with it. Here is the layout of the output ports, two USB-A ports. The first one is slightly more powerful, a lightning port for charging the power bank itself with iPhone cables, and the most powerful port, USB-C, which delivers up to 100 watts. Charging the device. Connected to a high-power charging station using a port capable of delivering up to 100 watts. The wattmeter on the cable shows 68 watts, while the power bank screen displays 63 watts. It charges quickly, taking just over an hour when fully discharged. Modes for USB-A ports. Power delivery, not supported. Apple charging protocol, supported, 5 volts, current up to 2.4 amps. Battery charging 1.2. A basic compatibility protocol with most devices, 5 volts, current up to 1.5 amps. Samsung AFC. Samsung's fast charging protocol supports 9 and 12 volts. Huawei FCP. Huawei's fast charging protocol supports charging at 5 and 9 volts. Huawei SCP. A more powerful fast charging protocol from Huawei. Supports a voltage range of 3.4 to 5.5 volts with a maximum power of 25 watts. Quick Charge 2.0, supported at 5, 9, and 12 volts. Quick Charge 3.0, a more advanced version with dynamic voltage support, up to 12.11 volts. Quick charge 4.0 and 5.0, the latest standards from Qualcomm are not supported. VOOC/Warp, charging protocols from Oppo/OnePlus, not supported. SuperVOOC, Oppo's faster protocol for ultra-fast charging, is not supported. USB-C port, power delivery, version 3.0. Maximum power, 100 watts. Number of PDO, power data objects, profiles, 7. Supports charging Apple devices at 5 volts and a current of 2.4 amps. Battery charging 1.2. Charging at 5 volts and a current of 1.5 amps. Samsung AFC only supports 12 volts. Huawei FCP, charging at 5 and 9 volts. Huawei SCP, voltage range of 3.0 to 5.5 volts with a maximum power of 25 watts. Quick charge 2.0 to 5, 9, and 12 volts. Quick charge 3.0, up to 12.11 volts. Quick charge 4.0 and 5.0, not supported. VOOC/Warp, not supported. SuperVOOC, not supported. Built-in USB-C cable, the same applies, except that the maximum power in power delivery mode is 60 watts. Now let's test the power of the built-in USB-C port. Starting with the 5-volt, 3-amp mode, I used two of the most powerful cables I could find, Ugreen and Baseus. However, they have their own influence. The voltage on the tester after one cable is higher than at the electronic load after two cables. Nine volts, same current, 3 amps. The voltage drop on the tester is less than 0.5 volts, which will be similar for a real load connected with one cable. Twelve volts, 3 amps. In the background, you can see that the power bank screen shows 38 watts. The tester shows 34.6 watts, and about 33.9 watts reach the electronic load. Fifteen volts, 3 amps. The situation is similar. As you can see, a lot depends not only on the power bank but also on the quality and capacity of the cables. Now I set the load current to 5 amps. I switch the trigger to 20-volt mode. This is the mode for laptop operation. The voltage drop on the tester is about 1 volt, and the actual power is 95.5 watts. This is quite sufficient for working with most laptops, which is the primary reason I purchased this device. Capacity testing. I decided to perform in a mode close to maximum power, 20 volts, 4 amps. The actual power on the tester, after one cable, was slightly over 77 watts, and on the load, after the second cable, about 76 watts. The power bank screen, at the same time, displayed 83 watts. I consider the tester readings to be the most accurate, and it would be similar under real load conditions. Now, we wait for real data on actual capacity. After 15 minutes, the power bank screen shows 50%, and the voltage on the tester has slightly dropped but remains at around 77 watts. Another 10 minutes later, the power bank displays 22%. The voltage has dropped a little more but remains almost at the same level. An interesting point. The screen shows 0%, but the power bank continues to work for quite a long time. This is due to initial calibration. After two or three cycles, it should stabilize and display accurate values. In this mode, close to maximum power, the power bank managed to operate for almost 46 minutes, delivering 57.5 watt-hours of energy. Considering losses across two cables instead of one, as would occur in real-life usage, the actual value is closer to 60 watt-hours. Given the declared capacity of 20,000 mAh and the voltage of lithium polymer batteries at 3.7 volts, the internal capacity should amount to 74 watt-hours. This means the efficiency, in the mode of stepping up voltage to 20 volts at such power, exceeds 80%, which is quite good. In gentler modes, this figure will be higher. This is a real use scenario with my laptop, average consumption of about 40 watts, with an expected operating time of around 1.5 hours. Another important point. It is best to connect the power bank to the laptop right away when the laptop battery is fully charged and all the energy is directed solely to its operation. If you connect it when the laptop battery is discharged, a significant portion of the energy will be used for charging the battery. Considering that the efficiency of the charging module is less than 100%, the overall runtime will eventually be lower. Additionally, the power bank's efficiency is higher at lower power levels, and such modes are less stressful for it. That's all for now. I hope this video was useful and interesting for you. I'd appreciate your likes, they help promote it on YouTube. In the description below the video, I will leave links to stores where you can order this gadget, as well as links to my Telegram channels, social media, and groups for discussions on smart home topics. Feel free to join. It'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention, and see you next time. Peace to all.